Hello everyone, welcome to opportunitycircle.com. We are back with another video. The SUSE Exchange Program is a fully funded program hosted in USA and for Pakistani students. Some more important information about the program is the funding of the program. US government will cover all participant costs including program administration, international and visa travel, travel allowances, domestic travel and ground transportation. Books, mailing and incidental allowances are also included. Housing allowance will be paid by the government and participants' international and visa travel costs and travel allowances within set limits if the program is conducted in person. A light on the eligibility criteria of the program. The applicant's age should be between 18 to 25 years. The applicant should be enrolled in a national college or university. At least one semester should be left. Medical students can also apply. Have a keen interest in the topic of leadership. Demonstrating strong English interest. Must be fluent in English. Should have serious interest in learning about the US. Should not have a dual nationality. Some benefits of the SUSE US Exchange Program. Get round trip tickets in economy class. Visa costs are all covered. Airport expenses such as $250, monthly stipend of up to $1,500 for the exchange program. Meals are also included in the program, breakfast, lunch and dinner. Full accommodation is covered by the government. All field trips within the United States, they will get a new iPad. Some more details about the program. Pakistani undergraduate students interested in the subject of comparative policy making are invited to apply towards the main part of the video, that is the application process of the SUSE exchange program. To apply for this exchange program, you have to complete an application form and submit it on the official email address. Only email applications will be considered for review. Take special care in answering the essay questions while saving the file and emailing the application. Kindly use the following format for the subject line. The format is given in the application process on the Opportunity Circle official website, that is that you have to send it in the format of name of the applicant, the name of the institution, city in which you study, for example like Musa Ali, IBA Karachi, Karachi. So now you can download the form by clicking on the apply now link. Here you can see the form is downloaded. Now you can open the form by clicking on it.
Are you enjoying the video? Do press the like button below and subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon for daily updates and latest content. Also join us on our Telegram to get daily opportunities directly in your inbox.
So here we have the downloaded SUSE application form. So the official application form which you can download from the apply now link as shown before in the video on the Opportunity Circle official page. So study of the US Institutes for Student Leaders Comparative Public Policy Making Program 2021 application form. Important note, the 2021 summer program may be conducted in person at the host institution, the University of Massachusetts in the United States, or as a virtual program with all lectures and activities designed for public synchronization and leading due to COVID-19 travel restrictions. Please know that even if you are selected for the 2021 cohort, you may not be able to participate in the in-person program. If you are willing to apply for the program, whether in-person or virtual, please fill in the form below and send it to us as explained in the announcement. Question before you start filling the form. We are working with our office in Washington on the placements. Did you receive selection offer during April-May 2020 for possible inclusion in 2021 program? Please state yes or no below. So here are the questions. A. Current academic institution and city name. In this question, you have to tell about your current institution in which you are studying and the city in which your institution is located. B. Candidate's full name exactly as it appears on your passport. Prefix, last name and first name. Gender, male or female, your date of birth. You have to spell it out as month, day or year, for example January 21st 1998, your city of birth, country of birth, your citizenship, primary and secondary if applicable if you're a citizen of any other country, your country, your current country of residence, your medical, physical, dietary or personal considerations, your contact information are to be mentioned in question J, your address, your city, home state or province, home country, residence phone number, mobile number and email address, your emergency contact, name and relationship of your emergency contact, phone number and email address. Question number L. In this question, you have to tell about your family, such as your parents, mother, father, name and their occupation. Address of your guardian, if it is different from yours, telephone number and email address. Then comes the section of your brothers and sister. You have to tell their gender, age, occupation and their name. You have to state the list of your siblings or relatives who have attended SUSI program or any other US government funded exchange program in the previous years, their name, their gender, name of the program and year in which they attended, your relation to them such as your brother, sister, cousins, etc., their current address and occupation. Question number M. In this question, you have to tell about your current education, academic and professional training, including degree earned and fields of specialization. You have to fill this form in the form of firstly the current education that you are studying in, degree, year in school, specialization, city, expected graduation date and grade and GPA. Your previous education, such as the degrees you've earned before, years earned, specialization and institution, city and grade and GPA. Then you have to tell about those your scholarships, if any, you've earned before, work and volunteer experience, membership in associations, clubs, etc. Previous experience in United States. Please list any and all trips the candidate has made to the United States and include approximate dates and reason of your travel. Previous experience in any other country abroad. Please list any and all trips the candidate has made to any country outside Pakistan and include approximate dates and the reason of travel. Purpose, travel dates, city or state and description should be provided in the boxes below. Question number S. Family residing in the United States. Please list any immediate family members, parents and siblings if unmarried and spouse and children if married who are currently residing in the United States including city and state. You have to provide their name, your relationship to them, their city or state and their occupation. Question T. Have you or any of your family relatives ever applied for immigration to the US? If yes, which year was the petition filed and was it approved or not? Personal statement. Please structure your essay in paragraphs and limit your response to 250 words, single spaced. Essays that exceed the limit are penalized in the scoring. Tell us about yourself and your goals, including the following. Why do you think your background and interests make you competitive for this particular institute? What will you contribute to the group? How do you expect this experience will affect your future academic and professional career? Question number V. Short answer question. Number 1. How essential is this policy to the success of a country on a government level? How does the policy-making sector work in Pakistan? You have to answer these questions. These are short answer questions and you have to answer them in about 150 to 250 words. You do not exceed this limit. Question number 2. Imagine yourself as a policymaker in the government sector of Pakistan as a young, energetic leader. How would you address potential consequences of having an outdated policy? The public affairs section of the US government will contact applicants selected for interviews based on the criteria as demonstrated in the application form. Interviews will take place in or around mid-January 2021, whether in person or virtually. Only shortlisted candidates will be contacted. The list of finalists and alternates will be announced by approximately mid to late April 2021. Selected participants will need to obtain passport and apply for US visas with the assistance of the Public Affairs section of the US Embassy. Students will receive orientation material in the weeks prior to the start of the program to help prepare them for the program and their trip to the United States. If it is an in-person program is conducted, participants may have an opportunity to speak with the Public Affairs section about the program. Subject to travel restrictions due to COVID and visa approvals, participants will travel to United States for the institute in the summer 2021. Thank you for your interest in this program. Good luck for your applications. Stay connected on the Opportunity Circle page and WhatsApp groups to get more exciting videos and more exciting offers to help you grow in your future. Thank you so much. Tune in to our YouTube channel for more videos.